We've already seen one way to create a bar chart using the frequencies command. We plotted the independent measure of gender. And we learned how to add error bars to repeated measures bar charts. So now we're going to plot a bar chart with error bars for independent measures using the chart builder. Then we can compare the error bars to see whether they overlap. When error bars overlap, that suggests the groups are actually pretty similar, even if one bar is higher than the other. But when the error bars do not overlap, that suggests that the group means are probably different. We're still using Clickers.sav. Be sure to use your new corrected data set that we fixed in the last video. This time, our research question is whether students who share a single clicker within a group prefer to have an individual clicker more than students who have individual clickers. And is there a gender difference in preference for an individual clicker? The independent variable was group assignment, shared clicker group versus individual clicker group. That goes on the x-axis. The dependent variable, or outcome measure, is the mean preference for an individual clicker. That will be plotted on the y-axis. Preference was measured using a Likert-type rating scale with scores ranging from 1 to 7, with 7 indicating a high preference for an individual clicker and 1 low preference for an individual clicker. Create a bar graph to determine whether students prefer to have their own individual clicker. So we'll go to Graphs and Chart Builder. We'll click Reset. And remember that when you're seeing variable labels, you can right-click or control-click to display variable names or to display the variable labels. Let's choose variable names. And now we're going to go to the bar option and drag the simple bar chart up into the canvas. This time we're going to drag the variable prefer to the y-axis, and we're going to split it by group. That will go on the x-axis. In the element properties window, let's make sure that mean is selected under statistic. We'll display error bars and leave the confidence interval set to 95%. The bar style is set to bar, so we're ready to go. Click apply and OK. Let's look at the resulting bar chart. We see that preference for an individual clicker was lower in the shared clicker group than it was in the individual clicker group. To interpret these findings, I want you to notice how the bottom of the taller error bar does not overlap with the top of the lower error bar. The non-overlap of the error bars is a good hint that these two groups are likely statistically significantly different. We should do a t-test to find out, but just from the graph, we can get a good idea. So how would you interpret these findings? We assumed that everyone would prefer having a clicker all to themselves. Using the preference of the individual clicker group as a baseline, we were surprised to see that preference for an individual clicker was lower in the group that had the experience of sharing a clicker with the group. One interpretation of these findings is that students who actually get to experience sharing a clicker with a group discover that sharing a clicker does not detract from the experience. Perhaps people think they prefer having an individual clicker because that's how clickers are typically used. Once they have the shared clicker experience, they realize that having an individual clicker does not really add that much. Certainly, the shared clicker group was not clamoring for their own individual clicker after the experiment. So reflecting on these findings, we begin to wonder if perhaps males want their own clicker more than females. Are females more into sharing? Is there a gender difference in preference within each group? We could answer this with an ANOVA, but we can accomplish it easily with graphing. I would like to examine these same findings, splitting them by gender. So how do we divide a bar chart by group and gender? We're going to go to Graphs, Chart Builder. This is the example that we've just run, and here's what we're going to do. let's drag the clustered bar chart directly on top of our previous analysis. We now see that it has added a new drop zone called cluster on X set color. We have our graph, our groups set as shared and individual, but we are looking for prefer. We're going to need to drag that to the Y axis where it currently says count to change that. Now for the cluster on X set color, that's where gender is going to go. We're going to subdivide by gender. In the element properties window, our statistic is mean. That's what we want. Let's display the error bars. Confidence interval is 95%, and the bar style is set to bar. Click apply and OK. We notice two interesting things in this split bar graph. The first is that the same pattern emerges for both groups. Preference for an individual clicker was slightly lower among males than among females. Another thing we see is the error bars for the two groups do overlap. This substantial overlap of the error bars suggests that males and females do not differ statistically significantly in their average level of preference. Again, we should do a t-test in order to make a determination, but the error bars suggest that there is not a gender difference in clicker preference.